All right, let's get back with our EBC Malaysia Bureau, where Gail Aldos will join us live. Hello, Gail. Are you there?
Hello, Alma.
Hello. Okay, loud and clear. I can hear you now. Go ahead with your report, Gail.
Yeah, here in the latest news, those who return home from overseas and refuse to pay quarantine charges or sign the letter of understanding will be sent to the Public Training Institutes, or ILA, said Senior Minister Datuk Seri Ismail Sabri Yaakob. He said these institutes belong to the government, therefore the returnees could be placed there without having to pay a deposit. He said in a statement yesterday, at the institutes, the returnees will be given 14 days to settle the charges of 150 ringgit per day. If they fail to do so, they can be slapped with 1,000 ringgit compound and court action. Ismail Sabri said the quarantine charges at hotels or at the public in training institutes are of the same amount. Meanwhile, he said students from the B40 families could seek exemption from paying quarantine costs by informing the secretariat on duty upon arrival at the Kuala Lumpur International Airport. Ismail Sabri said the secretariat would check with the Inland Revenue Board database and the eligible students will be given an approval letter that needs to be submitted to the hotel when registering for a room. For students who have graduated, only those who are under sponsorship do not need to pay quarantine charges because the costs are borne by the sponsors, he added. From July 24 until yesterday, a total of 5,281 people arrived at the country's entry points and were sent to 21 hotels and 5 institutes in Kuala Lumpur, Negeri Sembilan, Penang, Kelantan, Sarawak, Selangor, Perak, and Johor. He explained that of the total, 13 people have been sent to hospitals for treatment. Ismail Sabri said the returnees had returned from 28 countries. He also said police carried out 2,078 monitoring visits 2 days ago to check on individuals under home quarantine and took cumulative action against 80 individuals for flouting the standard operating procedures. He also included that the Compliance Operations Task Force conducted 60,856 inspections 2 days ago to monitor and enforce compliance with the Recovery and Movement Control Order, SOP, and detained 104 people for flouting the RMCO. Of this number, 5 people were remanded, while 99 were issued compound fines. Police had also set up 64 roadblocks in Ops Benteng nationwide to check the entry of illegal immigrants, and 5 people were detained for immigration offenses. Back to you, Alma.
All right. Thank you very much, Gail. Finally, you were able to make your report. Thank you very much, Gail, for your reports there, EBC Malaysia Bureau. Thank you.
Thank you, Alma. Reporting live from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, this is Gail Aldos. We live in interesting times.